today we'll be covering like if you have particularly decided that you want to go ahead and give a schooling for your preschooler rather than just homeschooling her, even for a few hours, a few days in a week, then what is the type of school you should choose, like Montessori preschool or the kindergarten, the traditional schools. So we'll be discussing more about like what are the basic major differences which I have seen when I was evaluating all the other schools for my daughter, like at 2.5 years of her age. Montessori is like more like a hands-on approach, which is like more of practical things rather than just a bookish thing. So they don't follow a particular a kind of curriculum or some so they have their own set of proven activities which they will be doing, and it is like more hands-on, which will help the child to develop their fine motor skills, their understanding about the thing. The other thing is they also are not like teacher driven. They are more like child driven, in sense that like for example, if your child is working on a puzzle or on any activity for that sake for some time, then it is not something that they can do this activity only for say 5 minutes or 10 minutes, like in a traditional based school. It will be like they follow one particular curriculum. So okay, they have to do rhymes for so and so, then now it's a play time, now it's a circle time, now it's this thing. But if your child is engaged in something, and they are focusing on something, they want to do something, they give that space to the child to discover it completely and get over with it. Teacher will not be intruding or taking the focus out of the child. From there, they will be helping the child, but not if they want to play further, then it's like timeless boundaries which they have. So till the time the child want to play with that toy or with that piece, they can go ahead and do and explore more on that. So it's not like time bounded in a particular curriculum. So that is another aspect. That, the lessons are like individualized. Now, for example, if my daughter is like at 2 years, she's aware of like all the alphabets, capital letter, like the uppercase, the lowercase, the numbers like 1 to 20. In fact, she can count from 1 to 20 verbally, and she can even recognize and even do counting. And then shapes and colors, counting she started like almost like after 2, but yes, but she knew most of the shapes, colors, A to Z, 1 to 10 by 2, and then by 2.5 we have slowly eventually even then came to the level of counting or so, and even other more vocab words. But then now if I send her to a traditional school, for example, then they will be having a particular curriculum, then she'll be asked to do whatever she have done already, like a letter a day or a letter a week, in fact a line, and then a number a week, and then some other activities on that few hours. But then it is like sending the child back to for me at least it was because her level was ahead to what is covered in a traditional school at 2 years of age here. So I was kind of feeling that my child is now like what she's going to do there, the curriculum which they are going to follow is like learning some letters or numbers which she already knew. So but the things are individualized in the Montessori school. So it is like every child is different and every child has different capacity. So if your child is bright and they know the concepts ahead, because you might be spending a lot of time as a mom or the parents, like anyone, mother or father must be spending some more time. So if they know the concepts already, they won't be doing that all over again. So they will be starting it from where this child need it. Like for example, now my daughter is into printing and tracing, so the school focuses on that. So they are not trying to teach A to Z, 1 to 10 shapes and colors at 2.5 years of age, what she would have done in a traditional school, which would have been of no use to me. So at least now she's doing something which I am doing currently, if nothing more, then nothing less also. Then the other aspects to it, like for example, the multiple age groups which they have. Traditional schools are like, grouped the children as per the age wise because they have a particular standard curriculum to follow. So they group the children below 1 year and then 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and so on. And then they have a particular curriculum, they have created a particular curriculum for them and then they follow it. In the Montessori schools, rather than those traditional schools, what happens is, like for example, in traditional school, since the school is divided in the age groups, a child of 2 years will not get to see the child, the class, the children of the class 3 to 4 or 4 to 5, like that. But in Montessori, it is not like that. Montessori children get to see, people of, like for example, like 2.5, she will be able to see children below her age and even above her age. So what is the advantage? The advantage is that, like for example, every child is like, they observe and they try to do it. They try to imitate and pretend like monkeys. More they observe and then they have some role models to do and perform some actions, then they also want to do something like that. So there are advantages and there are disadvantages also. But mostly, if like for example, I am sending her majorly to the school for the behavioral, social, emotional skills, it also helps that if she get to see a child of like 4 years of age who might be interested to do something, other activities, not the regular activities, some other activities. So they get to see that what that person is doing, and if she's interested, then even she can join her or him, on that activity, and she can continue to watch and observe even if she will not be actively participating, but at least she's trying to passively participate and try to develop her interest on that. And if she is interested, then later maybe she will be even actively participating in that activity at that age group, which someone of four years was doing that. So that is the advantage, where people observe, because children are like sponges, their brain is like so good that they can develop and learn quickly the things, they can grasp quickly the things. If they observe and they want to do something based on their own interest, then nothing like it. So first of all, that school has to give that environment where they are able to see children, above their age also. So at least even Montessori divides in the different sections. But I really feel that at early stage, it is a lot of good advantage for us, because like a child of 2 years, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year is able to see the child till 4 to 5 years of age. And that will make a lot of difference, in them, because they also want to do something which the other child is also doing. So then they will try to reach, their milestones also, because they want to do it, not you want to do it like as parents. So things like that get easier. So also like it is really right for the child, because as younger students, they are still developing the traits that will really help them in the school to become more respectful and more independent doing activities. So that kind of environment really helps. And also Montessori school, try to develop the traits like ordering, concentrating and coordinating and independence. It's more of that. So why concentration and coordination is like, for example, coordination is like there are some activities devised for that where you want to pour something in the jars, etc. Then it will help you with the hand-eye coordination skills. Those are the practical activities. And then there will be activities for the fine motor skills. But then all these activities require you to be focused and concentrate on that. So these are the activities, and like for example, and even they encourage that is that till the time child want to be focused doing only that activity, they're allowed to do that. They will not, someone else will not move the child from that activity to something else just because that he or she is taking more time on that. If he or she, that child, is taking, want to explore more on that activity, then they are allowed to do it because they are not on a particular curriculum or something. Devised curriculum that, okay, 5 minutes this, then 5 minutes this, or 10 minutes this. If they are doing something, they are working on something out of their interest, hence focusing and concentrating on that for a longer duration of time. So that based on their interest, so that helps. So that they develop in the, you know, Montessori school right from the beginning. So these skills definitely help child to perform a little bit better in the next years. According to me, that's the reason when I evaluated the Montessori school, give a better base to the child who is so small and young till preschooling years for that special education which is focused only on him, individualized, not on a particular curriculum. So that gives them ample opportunity for them to explore different areas. Now for example, she's 2.5 years of age, and then she happened to see a child of 3, 3.5 or 4, then she will be learning from them that if there is something which they are doing that interests her, and then she tried to do that, then she's trying to do an activity which is advanced to her level, and then she's trying to observe a lot, you know, children of her age which are even above her age group. So you try to learn a lot from your older siblings, right? Younger siblings are trying to learn from the older siblings because they try to copy them, they try to, you know, follow them. So that kind of thing, which I'm not able to give that at my home, since I'm not having any siblings of her or even cousins or even my nearby family and friends for that. But then she's getting that platform there in school for all those 4 hours and 3 days a week. So 12 hours, she's able to get that environment. So that is the reason which I what the primary reasons that I have selected Montessori over the traditional schools, even if I'm paying a lot for that school in comparison to the other schools. But then definitely I don't want to, you know, it's my personal thing. If you can afford, it's all up to you. If you can afford it, you can afford, and if you cannot, then it's okay. I mean, it's fine. You cannot do everything, you know. I'm kind of trying to save on all the other things and trying to, you know, have some budget for my daughter and send to her to a Montessori, a good school, which is a good school in my opinion, because to get them a good basic and the good start in the during early years is very much important for me. So that's the reason I have done. So as I covered, so there is no grouping of the people on the ages, one thing. Second thing is they try to observe the people of the different age groups, which is the older people, the older kind of the thing which you get from the older siblings. So they try to know more about the different activities which other people are doing. So they try to observe and try to do that. So that also adds to the skills rather than just some academic skills. And moreover, academically also, they are working with your child on the level where they are, not on the level where, you know, the age should be. So they are not having any norms or standardization on that. So that is the reason I'm sending, you know, I have decided to send my school, my daughter to a Montessori school in comparison to the other schools. However, I will be sending, I plan to send her to, you know, to the other available public school thereafter. There are magnet schools available with good focus on their educations from 5 years of age, but for the initial years I will definitely recommend that we invest good schooling from Montessori based schools. Thank you. Hope you have liked my video, and if you have liked it, then please give me a thumbs up, and also please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for any more updates and notifications. And also till then, Take care, stay blessed. Bye-bye. Enjoy with your little ones. Bye-bye.